People are our most valuable resource, and our future is in our schools. So we need to apply smart approaches to human resource development and management. This study aims at analyzing national policies and legal framework, identifying and analyzing VET providers in Kosovo, and setting criteria for selecting those to be supported by ALA 2 project, based on selected economic sectors. The study analyzes existing vocational criteria and standards applied in vocational schools, including the identification of new profiles and the harmonization of curricula with the needs of the economy according to the sector selected by the ALA 2 project. Kosovo has the youngest population in Europe and has high usage of digital devices, ranking 5th in Europe for homes coverage with internet access. Therefore, the STEAM approach, which represents the basis for the new horizon in Industry 4.0, should be applied in line with EU digital agenda and the entrepreneurial spirit. The study was conducted in the framework of ALA 2 project, based on the findings of the survey with the key stakeholders. The analysis of education training needs relevant to the labor market, as well as the analysis of strategic documents and European trends. The findings indicate a number of shortcomings in the education and training system in Kosovo, such as the system is fragmented and without a clear orientation towards labor market needs. The administrative structure is extremely complex. Responsibilities are distributed to several government institutions at central and local level. Schools are unclear about their institutional and functional interdependence. Vocational schools and vocational training centers have a limited degree of autonomy when it comes to managing funds and human resources, which are highly centralized. Data and evidence on how education or training has contributed to enhancing the skills of students or trainees are scarce and poorly documented. The role of social dialogue is deficient. The level of cooperation between schools and private businesses is also low when it comes to providing internship for students or trainees. There is a lack of cooperation between vocational schools and vocational training centers. The sector of vocational education and training is not sufficiently supported. The greatest support has been provided by donors. Based on the above facts, the study makes some recommendations. The governance system should set up a flexible system to strengthen businesses' VET cooperation, implement regular assessment and monitoring of students' performance, and employ responsiveness towards professional development needs. As a result of their collaboration, vocational schools should create learning package in collaboration with businesses, start the process of piloting, accreditation and validation of vocational school qualifications, starting with the most prepared profiles. The process of selecting directors, deputy principals and hiring new teachers should be harmonized, applying a unique legal basis for the whole country. Vocational schools should be provided with adequate equipment according to curriculum requirements and labor market needs, in line with new technological developments. Prior to this, it is particularly important to review and harmonize VET profiles with current labor market requirements and the economic potential of the municipalities where they operate. To facilitate and practice learning of students and to avoid potential health and safety risks, vocational schools and VTCs should provide student health insurance.